Hey everyone, I am about to get started working on building a computer for Christmas. Obviously, it's a little bit tight and it probably won't arrive in time for Christmas, but I'm excited. So, let's get started. First things first, we'll be installing the motherboard. The case I had lying around, the motherboard here is an Asus Tough Gaming motherboard. Got this from Micro Center. I don't live anywhere near Micro Center, but I had a friend that was kind enough to be able to pick one up for me. Side. Rest that on the top there. Standoffs. And all your documentation. Now, did I miss the screws somewhere? Or were they with the case, and now I have to go and figure out where the screws are? Luckily, I have a bunch of PC building screws. I thought your standoff screws normally came with the motherboard. Could be mistaken. You know, this is when you look at the documentation. There is a bag of screws, but it has two standoffs and like two screws. That doesn't look like the screws that it's talking about. One IO shield. That's unusual. But that's okay. That's why I've got my box of screws here. Why, especially when you do lots of computer builds, never get rid of your screws. It's important. Life lessons and all that. Screwing this down, need to make sure that this is the right screw head to use. Yep. Okay. First things first, we get the IO shield. I really like it when they have built-in IO shields, but I understand. Save a buck. Three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. Got it. Okay. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Nine. Okay. Well, that's not good. Ah. I went and put the IO shield at the front of the case instead of where it's actually supposed to go. Okay. That's much better. That gets the IO shield. Screw holes are basically lining up. Why aren't they all lining up? You're popped in place. All the holes are good. Ah. Much better. Much better. So first things first, doing the outsides. Of course. As I mentioned, I had previously built in this case, which means I've got some PC extensions that I will have to move. This is going to be a fairly simple build. It's a ginormous case, and that's because my previous use case for it was in a system that required a full tower, and I figure rather than buy a new case for this, I will just build in what I got. Beggars and choosers and all that. Interesting. The motherboard had an offset to it. Now, the plan for the hard drive, there was a sale on solid state NVMe drives, they're typically server size, but what I'm going to do is this board is more than big enough for that. Okay. Motherboard is in. Now, let us put our Ryzen 5 3600. Okay, I clearly must have missed something here. You know, I'm so used to installing Intel motherboards. Let's make sure I got this right. Don't want to screw that.
Intel uses pads. AMD uses pins.
CPU installation, put the lever up, make sure to align the arrows.
We're aligning the arrows, right? Oh, I'm not. That's why it's not fitting. Arrow is facing away from me. And that's why it just fits. It just drops right in. How fantastic. Okay. Cool. Okay. Let's see. Ryzen thermoplaced application. I've got my Gamers Nexus mat here, and you can actually see, let's pull this aside, it's got the thermoplaced application guide on which way to put the thermoplaste on the heatsink, line down the middle or an X. Probably go with a line down the middle. I wonder how they define the middle in this. Interesting. Hello, people in the chat. Okay. Motherboard's installed. CPU is installed. Heatsink and fan assembly. Apply the TIM to the CPU heatsink before you install the heatsink and fan if necessary. Okay. I was thinking about using a liquid cooler, but frankly, I'm going to be shipping this, so I'm already worried about it surviving across the country, and an AIO is kind of a little terrifying. This already has TIM applied. Do I care? Do I want to just use the stock TIM, or do I want to use something better? You know, I've got something better. I've got Arctic. I'd much rather use Arctic than whatever that slathering is on here. So, what they say is wipe it off with isopropyl alcohol. Conveniently, I also do 3D printing, and so I have a ton of isopropyl alcohol, 91%. It's not ideal that I'm using paper towel. Ideally, I would use coffee filters. I don't have coffee filters on me right now, but this will do. Also, IPA isn't a great cleaner. It's a good disinfectant and whatnot, so it's not great for getting the thermal paste off. But it'll do the job. The important thing is we want a nice shiny surface for when we install it. Get the big splotches off. Okay. That looks good. I kind of wish it looked a little bit cleaner. But I think that looks good. Okay. We'll run it down on a clean part of paper towel. Okay, we'll take a minute and let that dry. While that's drying, we'll take the thermal compound. This is Arctic MX4. That is too much. Better. I'm assuming that's the up and down direction. Well, wipe it off on the outsides. That's a little bit much, but it is what it is. Okay, you look dry. We'll put it up like that. So first things first, reading the instruction manual. I have never, at least to my knowledge, installed an AMD CPU and heatsink. So this just says that it snaps in. That doesn't look right. I wish it just snapped in. It doesn't look like it just snaps in. It looks like I have to screw those down. Are you sure it snaps in? No. There is the type 2. Type 2 means I have to unscrew those and screw it in myself. Why do I have to be lazy? Okay. Get my screwdriver. Okay. Now that those are out, let us
this over and install it. Now, that's annoying. There's no right way to do this. I want to install it like this so that you can see AMD up the side. This wording is facing in a uniform direction, so what I'll do is I'll install it like this. Miss something? Remove the screws and retention module. It says don't remove the plate. I didn't remove the plate, but there isn't a plate there. That's because the plate fell down. That's annoying. To try to blind mate a plate in the back of this to line up with all of the screw heads. This is not ideal. You know? Okay. Take that off. Try this again. Screw head. All those should be there. I believe the holes are lined up. Now I just need to get the darn screws to sit in. Says only to find out that the one hole isn't lined up. Okay, that is in, but it's too far in.
in. That's in. That one isn't it. You know, I like Intel's mounting better at the moment. Questioning if this is easier than the liquid cooling that I was originally thinking. Well, they normally say don't super wrench these things down. It's somewhat worrisome. Okay, I think that's installed. Let's just do a final dummy check just in case. Yes, in fact, I am the dummy. Okay. All of those are sufficiently screwed in. Now, CPU fan. CPU fan and a CPU opt. I'm guessing the fan is the fan, and opt is if you have a pump or something fancy like that. Okay, great. Dim installation. Okay, and if we look back here, it suggests a way to do the dim. Come on, where is it? Recommended memory configuration. So if you have to install them in dim B2 star and dim A2 star. That's unusual. Normally you would think that you would install dim in 1 and 2. That's strange. Before you would install it in DIMM. DIMM's A and B before you. A and B 1 before you install it in A and B 2, but. Okay. And so this has a fixed front and a movable DIMM in the back. Lock in the back. So this. For the DIMM, we're going with G-Skill Ripjaws. That should be good. So we'll open this up. Look at that. So much room. I almost feel bad with all these stickers because the case is mostly glass, so there's not really a place for the stickers. I don't know. We'll figure that out. Okay. Long end and short end. Does that line up? Click. Long end, short end. Click. Perfect. Also, thank you to Micro Center for the memory, because that was super duper on sale. Good times. Okay. So next they want the power install, eh? Okay. For the power install, I've got a Thermaltake Tough Power. That is as tall as that goes, I think. Anyway, Thermaltake Tough Power should be good. Okay. Toss that. Smart Zero fan. The fan does not operate if the PSU is low loads. Oh, that's fancy. On. Okay. So, nothing too fancy here. Okay, so let's flip this case over and get started. Thank you. Okay. Realizing you can't see, let's change the orientation. That kind of works. No, I appreciate that, but that's going to be difficult for me. So, we'll throw up the overhead cam. Okay. So this should be relatively easy and straightforward. Now the question is, do I want to install this I think I want to install this, you know, I don't know how this is going to be used, so I will install it so it gets intake from the case. I think that's the safer option. There is a filtered intake from the bottom. It's pretty decent size. Standoffs there, but it just seems like that would be the better choice because I just don't know how it's going to be used from that perspective. And if that gets in the way, I'll deal with it later. Okay, so yes, there are screws in here. Okay, great. So I was like, where'd the screws go? That's cute. They included zip ties. Cable management for the win. I have a bunch of spare screws, but it's always good to use what comes with it. Situated. Put the first one in. You can do it. Now that that's in, I get to deal with fun cable management. Okay. I know there's going to have to be a 24 pin, so we'll get started with that. Interesting. These is A8, one of them is not labeled. Let's see, okay. Luckily, it says 24 pin on the top and the bottom. what it is about power supply cables. They're always such a pain. I love you, Connor, but I am not doing fancy custom sleeving or anything crazy like that for this. It's just going to be run-of-the-mill. I'll try to do some tidying up and cable management, but nothing too crazy. Okay. That almost looks short. Should I be worried about this? I mean, I'm generally worried about this, but let's put the case down and see. Where is the 24-pin? 24-pin is midway up. What I'll do is I'll open up this, slide that off. All my pretty previous cable management goes away. And I'll route the 24-pin up through there. Once I connect that on the other side, I'll deal with zip tying things down. Do I want to do that now? No. I am going to do... Where is my CPU? CPU. Okay. Four plus four CPU. There's the next one up. If any of these are short, then I'll have to think about flipping around the power supply, since these are on the bottom right now. Big case problems, right? Okay. As the crow flies through the hole, oh, that should be plenty of room. Okay. Now, what's the best way to do this? Cable management time. Okay, so we want this to line up here. Of course, that is almost exactly where it does not want to line up, but it should work. Okay. That is good. Next, we've got the CPU 4-pin. Main lines for the 4 plus 4. Single plus four jumper. Okay. That's good. What is the Almighty Manual say is next? I put the Almighty Manual. Okay. Obviously, it's not cable managed yet, but I've got the 24-pin in, and I've got CPU power in. Next. SATA device connection. No. I don't have a SATA device, so I won't do that. Front panel I.O. Okay. This is going to be the fun part. So, on the bottom side, you saw all of the cables coming in from the front panel I.O. Now, I get to figure out how to run those through. I think... for most of them, I'm going to pull them up through here. Where is my USB 3 header? Really? Is there not one? No kidding. That seems like a mistake. Is it really not a USB-C header? Okay, internal connectors. There's the standard front audio. SATA. Not using any of the SATA, so that should be fine. USB 2.0. There's a USB 3.1. There is a USB 3.1 connector. It's a Gen 1 connector. Is that a different generation connector? What is that? That is a USB-C header. Crap. Well, that's not good. I mean, it's annoying. Ugh. Okay, well, that just means that there's going to be a port that doesn't work. It's annoying, but this is what happens when you use existing stuff. I don't think I've got a header card for that. Okay, that is a Gen 2 header cable, and I have Gen 1. Well, that's annoying. Let's see. There are plenty of things that will arrive here Monday if I want to get them on Amazon. Question is there anything that I could get that would be delivered tomorrow? I doubt it, but let's find out. I don't think this is possible. And I only have one USB 3.0 adapter, so I don't want to try to do that. Realistically, the best option would be a USB or a PCIe to Gen 2 adapter. So they make them, they fit in the PCIe X1 slots.
So, am I shipping this before Monday? Question is, would it reach if I was connecting down here? Because that's very far away. Okay. So, it has to be able to reach all the way to the front. I don't think it would. It might be able to reach on the inside. Okay. If I were to get a thing from a panel header, okay, I would be able to put it here. It's not ideal. It'd look like crap as far as cable management is concerned, but it'll work. Okay, we will momentarily leave that up top. And then everything else will go through the bottom. Yes, new PC build. Well, old case, new PC. This is why I just spent the last 5 minutes figuring out what the heck was going on with the USB-C header, because the motherboard that I got was not originally made for something that has a USB-C header. And so the case I had lying around, motherboard was new, but it's kind of the cheapest X570 case that I could get. And so I'm like, okay, good enough. Now we're seeing if we can do blind cable routing. Yay. Okay, this is just the standard USB-C connections. Those we will carefully there. And this is, what is this? This is audio.
know, that lines up almost perfectly with that point of the case. Rather than string it through there. Okay. Can I put this? Okay, audio front panel successfully routed to right next to the audio front panel. Perfect. Perfect. And now there's a front panel switch. Front panel switch. I think it's just a single cable. Okay. Switch. Power switch on the front. Now there is a fancy little LED bar in the front of the case, and I previously, rather than use the Leon Lee controller, because at the time I was like, oh, I don't need this crap when I was last using this case, I clipped that and set it up so that it could just plug into the addressable RGB header on a motherboard. Crap. That's gonna suck. Hold on. If it's not in the manual is what I'm supposed to do next, then I can ignore it. Okay. There's not a reset button on this. There's none of that stuff. Okay, cool. Fans. How many fans do I want to put in this? I hadn't thought about that. Hold on a second. Let me see what fans I have. Okay, three fans, the pretty Leon Lee fans, and of course they use the proprietary Leon Lee connector. That means I actually do need the freaking Leon Lee controller. Oh, where did I put that? Hello, Conda 430. I have no idea who that is. I have regrets. See, back when I got this case, I'm like, I'm never going to use that controller. I'm not going to use these fans because I have my fancy thermal take setup that I'm going to use. And so I had chopped the wires off the front here. I have regrets. Well, this is going to be fun. That is a lie. It will not be fun. Question is, do I try to figure out what the pinout is of the RGB and hook this back up so that it works? Or do I hook it up to the 12 volt RGB on the motherboard? So I just turned it into a 12 volt cable. It wouldn't be terribly difficult to figure out how to do this, but I don't know how much I want to do that. Do I even have this connector? I think that was one of the problems I had last time, is this connector. Crap. Can this just go in there? No. Of course I got the wrong connector for that. Well, it's not the wrong connector, it's just not the connector that I was using. No, separate spacing. Yeah, that does not fit. Why do companies insist on having so many different connector standards? Just why? I don't think I have that particular connector. I have lots of connectors. I've got JST, I've got 2.4, I've got all sorts of connectors. I just don't have that one. What do I do? Do I even have the pins that would mate with that connector? I don't think so. I think these are different pins, but I can find out. This is what you get when you have fancy stuff. Try to get fancy. Win stupid prizes, right? Okay. What is the proper engineering solution to this problem? I have 12-volt RGB header that I believe this Leon Lee connector would go to. Not the fan, where's the connector? So, this would normally want to go here. So that it could get the 12 volt signal, and that would signal it through the board. It doesn't even look like it's made to be able to do that. That's connects, it's not ideal. And then this would give it its power. Wait a minute, no, that's not what this is. This isn't for RGB. Oh, crap. This is just for the silly remote. So the RGB header would just control the remote. That's actually somewhat promising, because then, which one is these, the 12 volt line? Why are there only three wires? This is a 12 volt, not a 5 volt, right? I thought addressable RGB needed a 4-pin connector. Does it need all four pins? So this is saying 5 volt, 3 pin to 4. So I will probably do the fans on the inside, blowing in, give a good intake. Do I even want to put something on the pushing out? This will fit a fan pushing out. So what I'm thinking now is two fans. They're really nice fans too. Is a 5 volt. Okay. I'll have to deal with that later. Let's probably do two fans pulling in, one fan pushing out. That seems like a reasonable configuration. No one will get mad at me for that. Such a big case. Okay, back to my box of miscellaneous screws. Luckily, I separate the miscellaneous screws for fans from the miscellaneous screws from everything else. Sorry. These screws are more heavy duty. Hello, X-Poof. I'm not even going to try pronouncing that. Okay. So, I want this Leon Lee controller to be around the backside. Case was not made for such small fans. For those of you just joining, I am in the process of building a new AMD Ryzen 3600 system. And I got the processor and motherboard and RAM from Micro Center out of Denver. Thank you very much to my good friend Azriel for that, because I live in Silicon Valley and we don't have the beauty that is Micro Center out here. You go to Fry's Electronics and you will be lucky if they're open, and less fortunate then too, because they'll have nothing. If they're not shut down, because they've like closed most of those. Hate the fact that I'm OCD about these cables. Because that means I don't want to route them properly. Okay. So we'll put the cables in through there. That should be good. Cable management on the other side. Okay. Case is a Lian Li. I honestly don't remember what the case actually is. I got a long time ago. And this previously held my gaming and streaming rig, which is a Core i9. Super overkill case. Like, you don't need a case this frickin' huge. I had an EATX board, so I needed a case this frickin' huge. And I've been looking to try to get rid of the case, because aside from the fact that shipping's gonna be an arm and a leg, it's a really nice case. It's really kind of pretty. You know, now I'm torn. I want to take a poll. Does it make more sense to have the three Lian Li fans in the front of the case, pretty RGB BS, and then put a just regular black fan in the back of the case? Think that's what I'm going to do. I'm open to chat suggestions, though. If there's anyone in chat. I don't think there's anyone in chat. Yeah, I'm gonna do it. This is me trying to support the next generation of PC Master Race. My nephew, wanted a PS5 for Christmas. And if anyone is anyone, they know that PS5s don't exist on the market unless you're willing to pay thousands of dollars. And so I said, hey, sister, What if I could build a computer that is hands down better than the PS5, and you just pay me what you would have otherwise pay me for the computer? I'll get all of the extra components and everything so that it's all good, and he gets a computer that is going to last for a decade. That's what I like to do. I build overkill, and that way it lasts a decade. Okay. You know, if I'm going to put all three here, it makes more sense for me to route them down the bottom, because that's where the power supply is. Proprietary systems. Well, this is exciting, at least. I'll get to use these fans. I mean, they're really pretty fans. By the looks of it. Okay. Let's put all of these cables. In through there. Right, yep. Okay, so that's fans 1, 2, and 3. Where is my header board? Mainly fan controller. Okay, so this is 12 volt DC. And this is, what is this? I have to assume that this is RPM for, this is IBM, that's just wrong. This has to be RPM for the fans. So that will end up in chass fan probably 2. Where's chass fan 1? Chest fan 1, chest fan 3, chest fan 2, chest fan 1. Where is it? CPU fan, CPU opt, chest fan 1 right next to AIO pump. I am not routing it to chest fan 1. That would make sense if I was using an AIO. But I'm not doing an AIO, so yeah, that doesn't make sense. Okay, cool. So this will route to chest fan 2, and I'll just pull that extra space. The RGB, does this even have an ARGB header? Okay, so socket 1 for M.2 is off of the CPU. Socket 2 looks like it's off of the PCH. That has Aurora RGB headers, 4-pin 12 volt. Does this have any 5 volt? It does have a 5 volt. Okay, so I am going to be lazy. What I will do, that doesn't go in there, that's important. I will have the front line tied in to the 5 volt header. So it's not going to all be off of this remote. The front is going to be off of this remote, and then the fans are, or no, the front's going to be off of the motherboard, the fans are going to be off of the remote. Okay. It'd be nice if I could actually put in, I think that was one of my annoyances with this, is I can't put in an RGB signal. You can only run it off of the remote. All good. Let's get back to where I was in the manual. Okay. Expansion cards. Do I want to do the expansion card yet? Okay. Front headers. Should I skip over the fans? Okay. Just did the front headers, so I've got my USB 3.0, I've got addressable RGB, I'll cable manage that. Okay. There aren't 2.0 headers on this, which is fine. And so USB 3.2 Gen 1 is this. I have a Gen 2 connector on this board. I just placed the order from Amazon for that. Okay, expansion card installation. That's going to be my graphics card. Again, this is what I had available. It's not the latest and greatest, but it is good enough. This is a GTX 970. I got it with the original craze. Conveniently, it's Asus, and so it matches the scheme of the computer. So that is my old graphics card, and it's going to work fantastic for my nephew. And it will save some costs on the system, because you don't have to buy a graphics card. That's always a good thing, especially in today's day and age with ridiculous graphics prices. Okay. I'm going to regret that. I always forget if I use the top slot or the second to top slot. So I always end up doing it wrong the first time, and then moving it. And I believe I did it again, which is fine. Let's find out how wrong I was. Want you now? I have the benefit of having this ginormous case. Okay, yep, I was wrong. So we'll put that down. I don't know why. I know in the past I've seen some motherboards where they had a 1x PCIe in the top slot. That made sense to me. This doesn't make as much sense. Why you would have that? I guess it's a standard, isn't it? Is that okay? We'll throw in a couple of old screws. Things I love. Magnetic bits. And this fancy dancy driver. It just makes life easier, you know? Okay, that's in. That requires a PCIe 8X. Do I have a cable that doesn't have... So I think all of these have the branching. That would be the only thing that I would consider changing in this would be if I were going to do the cable management. One, it doesn't need to be red. Just why? Thermal take, or yeah, it's thermal take, right? And two, why have it branch? So if I do any custom cable management to this, it will be that. I likely won't, but if I'm going to be waiting for the header to show up, then I might get excited and go do that. Okay. Okay. Carefully. Ah. I remember this came with zip ties. Where are the zip ties? I could just snip off that connector. Actually, what I could do, that's tempting. Rather than snip off the connector entirely, I could snip off each of the wires going to the connector. I don't want the wires to be live in here, though, so, nah. Nope, not gonna do it. Start with this, and if I get excited, I will cable manage it more. I've got actually some extra sleeves. I wouldn't sleeve the entire thing, but it's something that I would consider. Okay. So we've got that connector. That's coming down. It's next in the manual. Expansion card is installed. M.2 installation. Now here's something. Do I use the M.2 right next to my... Do I use the M.2 right next to the CPU, which is going to be CPU-based? It's a third-gen CPU, so it would work at the right speeds. The M.2 drive that I have is not... It's not blazing fast, is what I'll say. It's not slow, it's just not blazing fast. And so there's a part of me that's thinking of using the hidden M.2 slot. Let's go back to chapter 1, where they tell you what's what as far as the connectors. Okay. For second gen, it would be PCIe 3. So this is a PCIe 3 M.2. It is a 22/110 length. So I could hide it underneath this heatsink. I think I might hide it underneath the heatsink. Just because that's easy. You don't have to do anything fancy. Just hide it underneath the heatsink. And then it looks even cleaner. Okay. You don't like that bit. So we'll go with this Okay. Layered. Interesting. I know of them from other places. Please remove before application. And of course, much like the other places I know of them, they're kind of a pain. Do I have a tweezers here somewhere? Really? Ah, that peel. That peel, though. Okay. It's interesting. This doesn't have a screw, but the screw for the standoff is the furthest one out. So I think this is just going to hold it down based off of that. I got this M.2 on Amazon for like $70. Super good deal. This is a 1 terabit M.2. This is meant to be an enterprise drive, and it's actually got the capacitors right there. That's what those yellow things are to help allow it to finish writing if in the event that it dies. So should be a super good board. It'll use a little bit more power as a result of that, but that's not a problem. Yeah. Okay. So this just slides in there. And it sits right there. And wait, really? The heat spreader is just not big enough. That's funny. Who did their, like, the benefit of having this heat spreader is really, it makes crappy looking drives look good. And then you make it just narrow enough that you can see the green drive underneath it. Like, why bother at that point? Like, you have this pretty thing, and then you've got the green drive underneath. Like, it's not a bad thing. It's just like, what are you doing? Why bother? I mean, it still looks pretty. Like, don't get me wrong. That looks gorgeous. It's just a personal preference kind of thing. Like, if you're going to go through the effort of putting a fancy laser etched heat spreader there, why not, like, go all the way? When all the way is literally just one step. Okay, let's put away all these extra cables. I think I will need a Molex connector for the fan header. I wonder, there's a part of me that I wonder if I could use the power from the computer chassis No, that's not what this is made for. Like, this is actually the power fan. I'll actually put in the Molex one. Makes sense. Okay. This is done. What's next? I'm running out of things to put in here. RGB header. I mean, I could throw some RGB in here. I've got RGB strips. I'd have to solder something up, but we'll see. That would be if I go above and beyond. Okay. Building part of it. I've got two installation. Wi-Fi antenna installation, I'll deal with that later. Rear IO, LAN ports. Is that it? Connect to headphone and mic. Okay. I mean, that's kind of awesome. Nice. Okay, cool. So that's good. We'll put this back on the front. Let's do some cable management. Oh, it was so pretty before. First things first, do I have zip ties? Yes, I do. Good. Because the three that came with the computer, or the hard drive, are not enough. I mean, I appreciate Thermaltake for providing zip ties, but not enough. Not enough. Not at all. Okay, so first things first, this will... What is this? Ah, front panel connector. So, I want to route the CPU up under this, because I can. That's nicely in there. The question is, do I zip tie that to itself, or do I zip tie it to this motherboard standoff? I think itself. Okay, so that nicely only required one zip tie. I will need more, which is good that I have extras. All This is going to stay up here until I deal with it. Now let's see. This is the switch. Where is the LED? Crap. I thought I pulled the LED through here.
I did pull the LED through here.
I mean, the whole point of this was to pull the LED through here. Hold on a second. Pretty Gamer's Nexus Pad. Cable. Manage. Manage. Ugh. Not a light case. That is around the USB-C header. Come on. That one was... Is it still around the USB-C header? Are you shitting me? Not be hard. Okay. Now you're in there. Bear with me a moment so I connect it. Okay. Two wires, one wire. Good. Okay. Addressable RGB connected to the motherboard. Good. Now, how do I want to do this? I think I want to go this standoff. This standoff, and then a little loop in here for this standoff. So what needs to be tied down now? I think only the internal standoff. So you don't want to pull too hard because that is connected to the motherboard right now. And if you know anything about RGB header connections, they're freaking finicky. Okay, I want to go there. Good, good. Snip that. Okay, next is next. for a second there. I was like, why did I put the graphics connection up through here? And I'm like, wait a minute, I remember the answer to this question. First, the proper response to a why question is no excuse, sir. Or ma'am. That's from my time in basic training. Now, I don't like that being around the power switch. So there's a lot of wires here. I'll manage them eventually. Okay, so this has to be plugged in here. Click. Click. Okay, click. Okay, the PCIe is there. That is tight. That is really tight. This is on the other side. I mean, I wanted it to be tight to the board, so I'm okay with that being tight. That's acceptable. Now, for this stuff, first things first, what can fit where? Because I think this has to be okay. So, nothing can come out underneath here from the cable management tray. So, it all has to come out the sides, which is annoying, but hey, whatever. I know the USB-C header is up there. But it does a nice little U here, so that's fine. This is the front audio?
Yeah.
Okay. And this front switch. Okay. Do we put that underneath the cover? So if it's going under the cover at the top, it has to come in the side as well. So I'm thinking what I'll do is I'll have a large cable bundle here of stuff that comes underneath. And then this is fan stuff. The fan stuff will go on top. I've made that decision. Maybe. I might be able to get the fan stuff on the back side of this. That would be pretty. That'd be really pretty. Okay. So, we know that we want something here. Do we want... I think I do. I think I want everything to come in from the top. Like this. And so it will lay out nice and neat here. And then, in order to force it in, I will use that. I'll use the far one. Did I run out of cable ties yet? Oh, this is why I have a bag of cable ties. Okay, so I'll use this far one. Well, these are shorter cable ties, I should have used these first. Whoops. Far one gets everything going in the direction that I want it to go. Then, I don't think I need to muck much with the SATA one. I want to make sure that it's not coming out. So what I'll do is, at the bottom here, the SATA 3 connection, Yeah, I wish I would have used the longer cable tie for this. Zip tie. Well, I have longer zip ties. They're just heavy duty ones. Okay. I don't want to crease that cable, but I want it to look good. Jeez. Okay. Now that that's there, should I do power first? I have to run a power cord to the fans. This will determine whether or not I can fit the fan header underneath. Okay. So, peripheral SATA. This comes up here. And where is the controller box? Okay. So the controller has its cable, so I can really put this wherever I want. So that's good. So peripheral SATA goes there. A ton of wire left over, which is annoying. This is the signal wire, I believe, for the fan controller. Because this is a fan and RGB header. What I will do is wire up the fans first. Come on. Okay. Do I know which one is which? I think, based on their length, shortest one is top. That makes sense. And then this is bottom, so this is middle. So I want middle to be fan 2. Top to be fan 1. And bottom to be fan 3. As a reminder, RGB is going to be nothing because I connected that to the case, or for the, sorry, the motherboard. So, the question is, will this fit underneath here with all of the other wires? I think it will. I think it will. And then, will I be able to connect to the fan header with all of the other wires? That's the bigger question. So this basically needs to peel off so that we can get the signal in there somehow. Okay. I like the idea of not connecting it to the flip-out portion. Like, at first I was thinking, oh, that would be really cool, but now I'm thinking it would make more sense to glue this down, kind of like right there. Fan controller header is like right here. Okay, so that's fine. That's fine. This looks like a mess, but it'll clean up really quick. So first things first, we move power, because power will be dealt with last. You know, I don't believe that Leon Lee, if they were smart, they would have fans 4, 5, and 6, and 1, 2, and 3 be independent. I don't believe that. I think Leon Lee didn't do that, and so I have to go in sequential order. I would want to do 4, 5, and 6 versus 1, 2, and 3 because of where the fans are in the case, but I don't think that's going to work. So, what I do is we'll paste that down there. Okay, now that is going to be our big kind of hold up for all this stuff in order to fit all the wires in. Now, like, the wires still look really easily manageable. So I'm excited about that. I'm just going to put the fan header off to the side here. Just put that in the front of the case so it's out of the way. Okay. Now, power, I'll deal with that in a minute. But as far as all the fan cables are concerned, they will come in through here. Nice and tight. I'll do one zip tie from this stand up. Inside of this, what I'll do is I'll bundle them and put it down. Do a zip tie here. Get all these where they should be. Tighten that up. Up real quick. Okay. Now for the meso cables. First, this SATA power. Oh god, it's so long. So very long. So we'll just use the first one. This is another thing, like, if I had my druthers, I would just make a new cable. I'm not going to snip this because there's only one of these that came with the power supply, so they expect you to have fewer Molex plugs nowadays, but it's just such a lot of cable. So, like, it's modular, yeah, good job, but it's not pretty. I think I can just loop all of that crap together here. More zip tie right where it kind of comes together. Okay, now that is there. All of that is together. This is good. Now we've got all of this wire coming out the same little area. There's a part of me that kind of wants to move this. But again, it's part part of the case. I don't really want to remove it. I just want to move it. And I don't think that's necessary. No, it's not really necessary. But those are rather large. So I will use the large zip ties. Of course, that bag is not open. Okay, the big zip ties. Now these, I don't really want to pinch a bunch of stuff. I don't want that wire. Like that wire, I'll just do a separate zip tie onto. So the plan is to pull this up, hook it around underneath, so there's cable hold downs on the bottom part of this cable guide. And so what we're doing is we're going around both of them because this is a lot of cables. And there's no need to cinch all of these cables in exactly one place. We just want them cinched underneath the cable guide. So it's better if we cinch them across the entire thing. Let's see if you can see that. Yeah. So it's better if we cinch it across the entire thing versus cinching it down to the cable guide itself. Like where you're going to cinch down to the cable guide would be like right here, down in the corner, because you want all of them to go right around that point. You don't need it there. There, it's just, you want it to keep underneath that. And let's see if I can do that again down here. It's a little tricky because you have to like get underneath and it wants to come out. But it's not bad. Okay, same thing. Now I need to think ahead. Actually, no, I don't. I was going to say I need to think ahead about the PCIe USB-C header. This is going to go inside the case, so I don't have to worry about that. That's going to be fine. Okay. Pretty cable management. Again, the goal is to have all of the wires come down and under this area. This is for a fan controller. I'm not sure where it is on the motherboard right now. So I wanted to just kind of come off to the side, and then I'll just use a small zip tie to zip it where it needs to go. And so now that it's there, I can put that through there. Like, if I were really good, I would have done that part of the routing ahead of time, but I don't need to. Let's see. In fact, the benefit of this is now I can use some of this bundle as a tie point for that versus the normal cable tie spots. I know I want it to be in line here. Okay, that's good. So do the big ones first.
that's in place. Tighten that to where I want it to be. That's in place. Now, all of these are hooked up to the fan controller. And now I should just be able to slide this on and slide this on. Okay, I forgot about the, it's important to avoid pinching. That's the downside there. Maybe I don't hold that down. That's just tight. Doesn't need to be tight. So I'll put it way up out of the way. Okay, so that's where that needs to be. The switch is where that needs to be. All of that is cable managed. And look at that, like the back of the case looks fantastic. And now the important thing is you do all of this after you already did everything in the front of the case. So now we'll turn it back around, and the only thing that should be left to do on the front is the fan header. And here it is, it's coming up right here, and I just slide it in, chest fan 2. And it's exactly where it needs to be. So it gets its PWM signal for the fan. All of this is through there, RGB. I wish this wasn't how it is. I don't think I can change the orientation of the... I think the heatsink is kind of the way the heatsink is. That's my understanding. I don't think I can change this orientation. Or if I could, I would have had to do that back when I was putting it down. Okay. So fans in the front, you can't really see any of that. Oh, there was an extra twisty tie. Not that I don't want to use twisty ties, but like I've got all of the zip ties in the back. That's fine there. Actually, is there a way that I could tie that down? I don't think so. Doesn't make sense to tie that down or mess with it anymore. The only thing left to do is I had talked in the beginning about having a rear exhaust fan. So I think I'm going to go and grab one of those.
choices. So, I'll put these off to the side real quick. So, what you're seeing here are going to be all of my fan options, if you will. So I've got a Thermaltake 140, another Thermaltake 140, an Antec 120, and just a generic 120. The Antec at one point was a CPU cooler fan. The reason I know this is because it has a 3-pin header. Where it is, I could use the 3-pin header next to the CPU. Well, it's a 4-pin header, but a 3-pin will work. Let's make sure. So this will be chat one. Yeah. So 3-pin will work. It's probably the oldest of these, but it should still work. I mean, 3-pin PWM, it's nothing special. It's actually only a 2-wire fan, so it's really just DC. Then we've got generic. I mean, that's fine. And that has a 3-pin with a breakout. I'll just snip off the breakout if I decide that path. But then I've got these 140s. And, oh, never mind. There's only space for a 120. So 140s aren't going to work. I could put the 140s on the top. This is not going to generate enough heat to ever need that much cooling. It's nice to know that it's there, but it's completely wholly unnecessary. Especially since I'm using the stock cooler. If I were going above and beyond and using the AIO, then I probably wouldn't even bother with this. I would just push out the top with the AIO fans. But this, I think I'm going to go with the Antec. We'll see how that goes. If it's not great, then I'll change. You can tell this was old because this was back before they bothered putting in the rubber gaskets that you see here. The other reason I don't want to go with the 140s is because I think they came with a case or something like that, because it has its own special fan controller, which is a 5-pin, which is their old version, the Thermaltake old version of this, and I just don't want to deal with that. So, what we do first things first. Sorry for the noise. Okay. Antec. All of these have Lianli up. This one, I want Antec out. Can I do that? No, I can't. So Antec is going to have to be up. Antec up, and I can do it. Good. So now, I think this was actually with a, it was for a radiator at some point, which is why I had the long screws in. Honestly, I don't remember. So we'll go back to the overhead. And now what I'm doing is I'm looking for my longer case fan screws, because it's going to have to go through not only into the fan, but it's also got to go through this rubber gasket. And now the rubber gasket isn't necessary, but I've got it, might as well, kind of thing. The neat thing about the rubber gasket is you can actually screw in the screws to the rubber gasket, which allows it to kind of hold in place. Normally you have to mess around with the fan and try to get it to stay in place and whatnot, whereas this is, the rubber gasket can hold it in place. It's nice. Okay. Let's get this started. The benefit of working it through the rubber gasket first is it kind of stretches out a bit. That's there. Sorry. Where do we want to put this? Because we can slide it up and down a little bit. I think I actually like it right where it's at. Okay, DC fan, hopefully it's not super loud. If it's super loud, then I've got at least that one option. Okay, that's pushing out. These are pulling in. Those are hooked up. The fan is hooked up to chassis 2. This fan is hooked up to chassis 1. We've got the CPU hooked up to CPU. I really wish this was not how it is. Everything else is so pretty. Can I do that? RGB is hooked up to RGB. You know, I might just throw a small, tiny zip tie around this to hold it in place. bad.
But the zip tie is basically a spring to hold it down.
Okay, so that's where that needs to be. We've got our drive in here. We've got all of the case headers in place. We've got the hard drive, or the graphics card, RAM. I think this is done. Nice! That's fantastic. Okay, so it only took about 3 hours to put it all in. Still yet to do is I'll get that header board on Monday, and then I can put that in here, and then I will... I hate the fact that that's going to be routed basically across the case. In fact, it should still fit. So what I might be able to do, in order to make it a little bit less terrible, in my mind, is route it underneath this and come up here, out the side. So that's something I want to bother doing now. You know, I'm doing all the rest of this now. I might as well do that now, so all I have to do is plug it in when it shows up. Okay, let's do this. The other benefit of having the cable management the way we did it is if it's not attached to this, then it's relatively straightforward to make minor changes like this. So we'll have that come out here. Is that where I want it to come out? Let's find out. Okay.
Pull up the other side. Okay. It's gonna be tight, but
I think that's where I want it to be. So what I'll do is a little bit of preparatory cable management, just while I'm at it. And I'm not going to tie these into the bundles because I don't want to find out that I need extra slack somewhere and have to worry about undoing the entire bundle. So I'll do the individual zip tie. It's not a problem. It doesn't look bad. And what we'll do is I will just let that come straight down through there, and then tie it to this zip tie for the giant bundle.
Okay. Snip, snip. Good to go. Now, this goes back on. All of the wires that are there are underneath. These captive screws are really nice. Okay. And that is that. All of... Now, obviously, there are some wires that I've managed to avoid by going down this path. You'll notice none of the hard drive trays or areas are populated. That's... I've got the single M.2 drive, and, like, I'm leaving the hard drive tray in. So, like, this should be able to expand a lot in the future. I think this was not there. I think this was supposed to be here. Question is, does it want to be there? Not entirely, but it'll fit. Okay. So this case is made up so that you can have 2.5-inch drives here, 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 here. This can be 3-inch drives, so these would be for 2.5-inch. If you go to the farther spacing, you can go 3-inch. Now, obviously, that would make it difficult with the wiring right here. You've got 2 3-inch drive bays here. Like, this case should never need to be upgraded. This is just unnecessary. Everything inside of the case, sure. But the thought process that I had was... make it so that it will last forever, and have good top-line expandable components. So the motherboard will allow using newer CPUs. The CPU will allow using M.4 or M.2 PCIe Gen 4. The motherboard will work with PCIe Gen 4. There's just so much expandability, where you could upgrade the graphics card, you could upgrade the CPU, you could upgrade literally anything in here, and just there's this constant ability to upgrade. So it's really nice. It's a good starter system. It's way overkill for a starter system, but it will last for a very, very long time, and that's kind of the thought process behind this. So, okay. Thank you to everyone that showed up for my stream. And I think I am going to sign off now. Yep. Okay, and Connor, if you've made it to the end, hold on, let me move things around a bit. That's interesting. Okay. Hey, Connor. Let's see. I'm gonna turn off my backlight. There.
There we go.
That's a little better. So, hey Connor, what do you think? It's basically all done. I just need to throw the operating system on that. You'll get Windows 10. But, yeah. Pretty sharp. You got this extra cable in here. That is going to be for the card that will show up on Monday. Hopefully everything will fit. If not, it'll work. But yeah, it should look good. You'll have RGB. Some of it will be on the remote. Some of it will be on the motherboard. And yeah, it should be good. Merry Christmas. And have a happy new year.